Tetsuo. No, no, stay back. Tetsuo, I can't get that close. I think he's okay. Hang on, I'll know in a minute. Pull him over here. Tetsuo, are you in there? Wake up. Tetsuo. Tetsuo? It looks like him. He's awake. Tetsuo, my name is Dr. Andrew Michaels. You're in a quantum
time bubble.
That's the world you perceive around you. It's okay. You won't be harmed. And you can't be harmed. I'm here to help you. You've been infected. Do you understand me? It's all tangled up. This is the connector end. If we can get that off. There you go. Do you understand me? There's one spool gone. That's what you're infected with. You're infected with metal. Are you remembering? There's a very small piece there. I gotta get it out. I just need my wire cutters. Maybe I could do it with them. How's that feel when I pull that out of your body? Do you feel better? You This is a mess. You are a mess. This is gonna take a while. But you're gonna be just fine. Okay. They call you Tetsuo, the Iron Man. But you're not an Iron Man. You're full of this copper wire. And the infection is making you sick. I got that one. Your biological tissue is trying to manipulate. It's trying to combine with the ferrous and non-ferrous metals inside your body. And it can't. It can't combine those two materials. Your carbon-based life form and hold on. Relax. Your carbon-based life form and this interference is making you ill. Oh boy, that's a big one. There you go, look. That comes a clean cut. All right. I'll lay it on over here. I have like a pool of wires. Now. Okay, that's the one I was looking for. Get that out of his leg. Okay, look at this. How are you supposed to function with this inside you? Thank you for disconnecting that, Amy. Okay. Look at that. Look how it... the wire tried to enter your arteries and your veins. This isn't healthy. This isn't normal. This is an abomination, even for a creature as yourself. She is my assistant. Her name is Amy. She's harmless. She won't hurt you. She's just helping me get these wires untangled from you. Here's one right here. There, it's not long. Well, if you're in trouble, you definitely want someone like Amy around. I swear, what a tangled mess this is. Recently, I had some problems, and I didn't know quite how to deal with them. But one problem I didn't have was Amy. I never had to look over my shoulder to see if I was still with her. Some friends are like that. Okay. I have to tell you something. Keep pulling the wire out. Oh, this one's a mess. Keep pulling them out. This is just a small piece. That longer one, we're going to have to get that. I swear it goes all the way to his aortic cavity. Here, cut it off with this. I know it's crude, but cut it with this razor knife. Yeah, there you go. And then you'll be able to pull it better. I'll use this to get it. Oh, it keeps pulling out. There we go. We're getting somewhere. Hold still. Calm down. Calm down. Nobody's trying to hurt you. Nobody's trying to hurt you, Tetsuo. You can't help what happened to you. Here we go. The spaghetti's all coming out now. There we go. There it is. Look at that. That was inside you. This was inside you. This is what we're trying to tell you. Your mind starting to clear. Do you remember who you are? No, no, no. You're not human. Stop that. Human beings can't do what you do. Human beings can't change their physical form. You were modifying on your own. Do you remember how you got here? What's your earliest memory? This is the one holding him up. Right here. That big long white cable. Pull that one out of him. You don't remember? Here, I got it. Ugh, get it all over me. Okay. You were... Let me get this out of him. Maybe then he can... His memories will clear up. Look at that. That's trying to connect with your body, and it can't. It's infecting you. It's like an infection inside your body. Do you understand me? Okay. He's coming around. Let me try and talk to him. That might work. I don't want to reach in there and get that. I'll use this. It's just a small piece, but I think it's preventing his lobes from regenerating properly. There it is. Look at his face now. See that look of recognition? This was inside your mind. That's right. That's right. Go back. Calm down. Go back in your memories. You're not a machine. You're no more a machine than I am. You're a Tetsuo. And Tetsuo isn't even a human like I am. Keep going back. Thought you were a man, then you thought you were a machine. Now let's go backwards. You're not a machine. You're not the Iron Man. You're Tetsuo. You're Tetsuo the human. You're not a human. You're something else than human. Go back. Go back in your mind. You're not a human. You're not even from this earth. Do you remember now, Tetsuo? Do you remember now? There it is. He's starting to remember. We'll get the rest of the wire out. I'm going to switch gloves so I can help you more. Plus my nose itches. Here. Have a cigarette. It'll help calm your nerves. That's right. Calm your nerves. It's all right. We all have to go through these things sometimes. We've had a psychotic break. I'm gonna help you remember. So stay with me. It's very important you listen. Amy, keep pulling those wires.
There you go.
Okay. All right. Now, this one's especially tight. We're going to finish up, and we're going to talk. Do you remember the before time? Do you remember the ship? The ship had a hull of magnesium. That's right. It was a flying disc. That's right. You were sent here from a kingdom far away. And that kingdom doesn't even exist anymore. They've long since vanished. They didn't understand properly. Their calculations were wrong. And in their time dilation, they sent you to the wrong time period, to the planet Earth. Your ship crashed in an icy, forbidden continent named Antarctica by us, the humans. In Antarctica, it was buried in the snow and ice for 20,000 years. You were buried in the ice with your pilot for 20,000 years. And when man finally discovered your ship in the early part of the 20th century, he tried to free it from the ice using a thermite bomb. And when they detonated the thermite charge, it's stuck in there. Hang on. Let me get this out. It's all over the place. This might be the last big one. It's coming out. It's almost out. There's just pieces. Cut. I don't like that. That makes me think there's still more in there. It's possible. This connector bothers me too. What was it connected to? We have to make sure we check for neurological damage. Can you move your arms all right? That's right. That's right. Move your arms. Very good. You look good. You're looking better. You can assume the shape in the form of Tetsuo that you're comfortable with. Okay? Alright. Alright. When the thermite charge went off, it caught the magnesium hull of the ship on fire. It melted the ship away. It burned it up. It burned your crew. There were very few survivors. We didn't know what we were dealing with, and they took the burned body of the pilot back to their station. Do you remember that? Do you remember how you came alive in the heat of the fire as it melted the ship? How you tried to blend, mold yourself to the metal around you. You tried to combine your life essence with that of the metal engines of the vehicles around you. They didn't even know you were there. They didn't even know they brought you back with them. They thought they only had the one body, the pilot. They were unaware. This won't go. They were unaware of your presence as you coiled and wrapped around the motor of their vehicle. Hold on. I'm just cutting these ends off so your hand will be more comfortable. There you go. Does that feel better? Can you move your fingers now? I missed one. Okay. Bring it here. Our technology has increased. We understand you now. We understand that you are what we call collateral damage in a war zone. We know that your intent as a species is not to be a harmful creature. We know that you can divide yourself many times, but as you divide yourself, you're still one creature a living, breathing, mimicking amoeba of whatever you're trying to mimic and imitate. We know that you genuinely do not wish to cause harm, that you're only striking back through environmental reasons. When you are attacked, you attack back. We know that now. No one will harm you as long as you're with me. And when we're done with this procedure, I'll take you to a place where you'll be safe. You don't have to fear mankind anymore. But there's a catch. Mankind doesn't want to fear you either. We have to coexist. We're going to place you on a beautiful island. There will be all the material. I thought we got it all out. I don't even know where this one came from. We'll place you on an island that's been abandoned after World War II. It's radioactive from atomic bomb testing. No one will go there for 50 years. This one's huge. All right, I'll give you a hand getting it out. Oh, it's tangled. There's a knot in it. I got it. This is the end. See, it's coming up. It's gonna take time to get all of it out. It's gonna take time, okay? But you do remember the ship. Do you remember the explosion? The hull burning? Do you remember being bounced out of the crater towards the motors? Do you? Okay. Do you remember trying to combine with the motor, the engine on the vehicle? The snow vehicle. Do you remember? Yes. Now, this is the problem. I have to bring all of your people who survived that crash back together. They're on the planet Earth, and they're in the same state of confusion you are. They've tried to meld with the human mind. With their telepathic abilities, they've become insane by perceiving all the thoughts of the human beings around them all at the same time. That's why I have you inside this quantum time bubble with just myself and Amy, so that you will feel safe. Okay? There you go. No, it's all right. There you go. Calm down. Don't get scared. I'm right here. I'm right here. I'm right here. It's okay. I'm right here. I know what it's like to be alone. And I do know what it's like to be left behind. It's okay. Calm down. It's gonna be all right. No one's gonna harm you here. There you go. There you go. All right. That's right. You don't have to help me gather the other people, but you have to help me find them. I know there's one in Antarctica. The pilot. We have to go find him. They call him the Thing. And there's another one in Neo Tokyo. We have to find him. He doesn't come up until way late in the game. We can travel to get him. And his name is Akira. And the fourth one is you, Tetsuo. Now you heard me right. Akira and the other Tetsuo have found each other. Your twin Tetsuo has found Akira. they destroyed Neo Tokyo, almost leveling it to the ground. And we need your help getting all of them back together. I need you to help me locate the frozen body of the pilot. I need your help when I find them in convincing Akira and Tetsuo that they're not human, that they're not espers, they're not telepaths, that they're aliens mimicking human DNA. I need your help, Tetsuo. You're the only one I can count on. And I knew if I pulled all this metal making you sick for the last 100 years out of your body, I knew you would come around. Do you understand me? Very good. I'm going to check you with a magnet for ferrous metals. Sensing any in your face. That's good. As long as your mind's clear, you'll be a lot healthier. Let me look at the end here. Now see, there's some filings. Here, take a look. Come here. See those filings on the end? Right there. It's okay. That's what I'm talking about. We're going to have to put him in a circular magnet scanner. Yes, those medical ones they've been developing at Johns Hopkins. Have to put him inside one, and it'll pull all the metal out of him. It will be painful, but you'll be free of it. We have to get you 100% metal free. What the metal fetishist was, it was a version of you, and it wanted to combine with you. It was trying to seek out its own humanity in a deformed sexual fantasy. It thought it was a human who enjoyed the metal inside its body, the pain overwhelming its morality and its ethics, and it couldn't cope with the psychosis it was going through alone. It was basically your body, Tetsuo, your body separated. It didn't know it was even part of you anymore. Now, once we have started the process of pulling you, all this metal out, that entity was reabsorbed into your body properly. There's only one creature, and the one creature is you. It is possible that all of you are one creature, but we believe we sense four separate entities. It is possible your twin is you. But we won't know until you two try to communicate by melding. We know you were sent here to destroy us. But the race that sent you to destroy us is long gone. We have friends. We have friends from the stars. They dealt with your overseers in the past, your masters, yes, they knew of them too, and they knew of how they would send out their pilot ships to destroy planets to colonize. Your masters are no more. They were wiped out of the universe 10,000 years ago. The only vestiges of their empire on this plane of existence are you survivors spread out amongst the stars. All the other alien races have learned how to deal with your mimicking their physical DNA, and they've given you all a place of peace. You know I'm not lying. We've given all of your kind a peaceful place to rest and live out your time. You know I'm not lying because you can read my mind. I know the more you perceive from the wires, the metals being pulled from your body, that I am telling you the truth. You can read our minds, and you know we mean you no harm, but you also know that great harm to this planet has been done by your kind. We need to reverse that. We need to bring them back and put them on the Bikini Atolls that are so radioactive they'll kill humans, but your kind can live there in peace. You'll be well supplied. You'll live out a life of luxury and comfort. No harm will come to you. There you go. Now you understand. My government sent me here. Let me get something. Let me get something for you. My government sent me here because they knew. I can't get them. Here you go. Here you go. These will help you calm down. There you go. They knew I could talk to you. I've dealt with your kind before. People not of this earth. I see life in a different way. It's time to heal. It's time to stop. Bring the pieces of your body together and let you have the peace that you deserve. You fought the good fight. The war is over. You did your diligence. At the end of all wars, it is time for the sailors and the warriors and the soldiers and the generals to go home. To go home and have the peace that they fought for. You deserve the peace be granted to you that you fought for. There you go. I know what it's like to feel like a machine sometimes. Like you're on a treadmill that's never going to end. And I know what it's like to feel like a machine. Something that can't be turned off. Something that can't stop. Won't stop. You and I, Tetsuo, are not machines. And we need our rest. And by the grace of God and the treaty that our peoples have signed in the past, you can see it in my mind. Can't you see it? Deserve that measure of peace. Okay. Alright. There's just a tiny piece right there I want to get out. Get my tool here. Hold still. I just want to get that right there. Oh boy, that's tiny. There, look at that. Look at that. That's the one. Right underneath your eye. I bet that hurt. There, get that out of the way. Can you locate the thing? Can you locate the alien pilot? You've got to be kidding me. He's found the mountains of madness. Oh my God, we're in trouble now. Oh, we're in trouble now. Oh my God. He's found the mountains of madness. Amy, call them out. Call my friend Lamont Cranston. Tell him I'm gonna need his plane right away. Okay, thank you. Goodbye, Tetsuo. We'll see you soon. Bye-bye.